On today's episode, why there's nothing to fear from AI. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. Are you afraid that artificial intelligence will send the world into some kind of dystopian hellscape seen in movies like The Terminator? Worried that artificial intelligence will run out of control? Concerned that it will eliminate everyone's job and create mass poverty? Well, that's a popular storyline, but I'm more than a little skeptical that AI is the road to ruin. Let's do a little thought experiment. Imagine that you're given a simple task. Drive to your local 7-Eleven for a Big Gulp. Now, you know your current location and you know the location of the 7-Eleven. What's the most efficient way to get there? Now, if you've never been before, you could consult a map, then make a decision based on the shortest route length, or perhaps one that uses streets that you know to be relatively traffic-free. If you were a computer algorithm doing the same task, you might virtually attempt every possible route to the store, measure the distances or the travel time, then choose the most optimal one. At a higher level of sophistication used by some traffic apps like Waze, real-time data is fed from other vehicles already operating in the local environment to flag the algorithm about routes that are clogged, suggesting a new optimal path. But the algorithms operate the way a small child would operate. Try everything, then learn by trial and error. Now, the concept of artificial intelligence is that it would operate the way we humans do. Look at an overview of the problem, then immediately select a perfect or near-perfect solution based on common sense and our existing knowledge of how traffic operates. But from an end-user perspective, what difference does this make? An unintelligent algorithm that operates with hardware that can execute instructions so fast that billions of iterations can be worked through in milliseconds will deliver exactly the same outcome, and the way it was derived will be imperceptible to you or me. In other words, artificial intelligence and relatively unsophisticated iterative problem solving is indistinguishable if it delivers the right answer quickly. But notice that the key factor isn't how a computer generates an answer, it's the context built into the question. Now, in my thought experiment, your goal isn't to discover the fastest way to that 7-Eleven at 8 o'clock on a Thursday night, it's to get a large soda. Systems like Amazon Alexa or Google Home are better at handling natural language queries. Ask it where you can get a large soda, and these systems will give you several options. But no matter how sophisticated the AI, they are constrained by the context built into the syntax of the query, which means humans are still invaluable. Now, in my thought experiment, if I asked my wife which was the quickest way to the 7-Eleven, her answer would likely be that I drink too much soda anyway, and that caffeine is a bad idea this late in the evening. Because she knows why I'm going without me telling her. Now that's intelligence, and I don't think I'm going to live long enough to see a machine that can do that. If you're an engineer, the lesson is simple. It isn't about the answers, it's really about the questions. Get the questions right, and it's relatively easy to get the answers, whether you're plotting a spacecraft trajectory or designing an electron microscope. AI will be the best tool that engineers ever had, and better still, it isn't going to replace anybody. Well, that's it for today's episode of End of the Line, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, Designing the Future, and the Engineering Roundtable, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.